What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode. My name is Mark, and on this channel, we talk about tech, life, culture, breaking news, capitalism, pretty much anything that is interesting we're going to talk about on this channel. So we're going to give you a quick rundown on the latest breaking. There's actually a three-week lockdown being imposed this Sunday. It is December 6th right now, Saturday, December 7th. There's a three-week lockdown happening in California, one of the first states to actually impose this second lockdown to happen since the great pandemic. And people are freaking out about this because they're going to be locked down, only essential workers allowed out and about. Lockdown imposed for 3 weeks into Christmas, and this is probably the first domino of many dominoes about to fall all across the nation. We're gonna go ahead and check out, there's some headlines right now that I just wanna look at. We're gonna go to our split screen. California will impose its strongest virus measures since the spring. And this takes place in Los Angeles, California, the first state to impose far-reaching lockdowns because of the coronavirus, announced on Thursday its strictest new measures since the early days of the pandemic in efforts to keep the surge in cases from overwhelming the hospital. So apparently, Gavin Newsom broke the news about this stay-at-home order just about a day ago, and it's due to the hospitals being overwhelmed. Now, I'm here in Tennessee, close to Nashville, Tennessee, and we get reports. I hear reports every single morning while driving, and I hear talk radio how they're talking about Vanderbilt being almost at capacity with their beds, and how people from Kentucky are driving and they're having to pass local hospitals because they're already full, and they're having to come into Nashville because we have a bigger space. And as soon as that space is completely taken up, this is going to be some bad news for the surrounding states, especially Nashville. There's going to be some lockdowns that are coming. And what they might try to do is lock us down until Christmas. And you know what? Because they locked us down the first time, it's so much easier to now lock us down the second time. And it's going to be even easier to lock us down the third and fourth time. And this is going to become a perpetual habit that happens coming from our government. When any type of crazy scenario, pandemic or scare happens, people are just going to, the government's just going to say, all right, lockdown, you're done. Nobody can travel. And it could just continually get worse and worse and worse. Now, I'm not trying to preach all doom and gloom right now, don't get me wrong, but when you control the people and you've gotten to a point where all you have to do is snap your fingers and the people start to listen, depending on what scenario happens, regardless of what scenario happens, you start to really tread on a fine line of kind of like dictatorship versus, you know, so we have to just be careful. I know we want to protect our citizens, protect the community around us, and make sure that we're not, you know, being irresponsible when it comes to this sickness and this disease. But at the same time, we need to question everything. We need to kind of question what's going on and why they're doing this and what the long-term effects of having these lockdowns to happen every couple of months. Now, what happens if the pandemic comes back every single year? Are they going to require us to lock down every single year? We're going to go ahead and check out on CNBC News, Rick Santelli and Andrew Ross have a heated engagement about the lockdown and about whether, you know, locking down restaurants and shutting down restaurants are appropriate and having other types of businesses open. So let's go ahead and check in and hear what these guys have to say. Now, as disclaimer, they get in a very heated debate and a heated argument. It's probably not the correct way to handle a situation like this, but people's emotions are involved right now. And so this guy's pissed. Let's check it out.
You can't tell me that shutting down, which is the easiest answer, is necessarily the only answer.
Rick, as a public health and public service announcement for the audience, the difference
Who is this?
Hold on. The difference between it's Andrew.
Who else?
The difference between a big box retailer and a restaurant, or frankly, even a church, are so different, it's unbelievable.
I disagree.
You're wearing a mask.
You can have your thoughts and I can have mine.
You're required to wear a mask.
I disagree.
It's science. I'm sorry. It's science. If you're wearing a mask,
science.
It's a different story.
500 people in a Lowe's aren't any safer than 150 people in a restaurant that holds 600. I don't believe it. Sorry. Don't believe
okay.
it. And I live in an area where there's a lot of restaurants that have fought back and they don't have any problems. And they're open.
Okay. You don't have to believe it. But let me just say this. You're doing a
I
disservice to the
won't.
Viewer because the viewers need to
you
understand it.
You are doing
it.
A disservice to the viewer. You are. You are.
I'm sorry. If I would like to keep our viewers as healthy as humanly possible. The idea of packing people into restaurants.
I think our viewers are smart enough to make part of those decisions on their own.
Completely different
things. I don't
think
that I'm much smarter than all the viewers like some people do.
Can I get in here?
Now, it's very interesting. You know, they're talking about shutting down specific businesses, keeping other businesses open. What's the difference between, you know, 500 people in a Lowe's and 150 people in a restaurant? You know, and so that's really up for debate. And now the mask mandate can be questionable as well. Does the scientific evidence prove that it will keep you any healthier than if you don't wear a mask? And when it comes down to people screaming and arguing, it's not the way to handle it. But I thought this was an interesting news clip that I saw, and I wanted to just kind of get your opinion. Weigh in down below in the comments. Let me know what your opinion is when it comes to the lockdown. Should there be a mandatory lockdown run by the states or the government, or should people be left to make those decisions on their own? Or are people responsible enough to make those decisions on their own? Now, you know, that's, again, up for debate. Different people have different answers. So I want to hear what your answers are down in the comments. Leave your opinion, leave your suggestions, leave your comments. And if you want me to cover anything else on this channel, definitely let me know. Guys, really appreciate you jumping on this quick update video. There's this breaking story that's happening about California being locked down for the next 3 weeks. We're going to see what other states are going to continue to impose a lockdown. And if you are in a state that is currently has a lockdown right now, let me know in the comments as well. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Guys, live well, laugh a little louder today, and learn to be a better you. We'll see you in the next video.